protesters besieged the Nigerian Police Force headquarters in Abuja, demanding for an end to rape and stiffer penalties for sexual and gender-based violence offenders. The protest, led by a coalition of civil society organizations, including the Action Aid of Nigeria, the Dorothy J. Meze Foundation, the Connected Development Code, and several others, demanded the investigation of rape cases in Nigeria and prosecution of culprits. The protesters also shamed rape apologists and others who have played a role in silencing rape victims and sweeping the case under the carpet.
Head of the sexual and gender-based violence in Nigeria, children are dying, women are dying. Enough is enough. We are tired. As a matter of urgency, we want the Nigerian politicians, those in elected office, those in appointed office, those that are not yet in any elected or appointed office but identify as politicians, to know that we are watching every step of everything they do and say on sexual and gender-based violence. We have made a firm declaration that anybody that does not endorse the Child Rights Act and Violence Against Persons Prohibition Act has no place in government. And come 2023, we are beginning to galvanize towards that because we are tired. We need to see budgetary allocations for real-time interventions in sexual and gender-based violence. We need to see a deliberate increase in ensuring independence of the police in investigations. We need to ensure that police doesn't need to collect money from survivors, because many of them are children, many of us are indigent, and we cannot afford these things. And you can hear, enough is enough. That's a firm commitment. So we're requesting, before the end of next week, we want to have in very clear terms a state of emergency declared against sexual and gender-based violence in Nigeria, so that we can have timelines and monitor. Those that haven't implemented the Child Rights Act and Violence Against Persons Prohibition Act, when are they going to do so? We need firm commitments. We are tired of the stories. We are tired of the photo ops. We are tired of being used. We are tired of parading us to use the stories of how we are raped and violated, you know, to make people cry and that is where it ends. No, we want to see real-time things. If it happens to you yourself today, anyway, the people I'm talking, the people in office, they have the money. Realities were not taken into cognizance. When
the first PRO, DCP Frank Kumba, while addressing protesters, expressed the commitment of police force in the quest for a rape-free Nigeria.
Therefore, we are together with you in the quest for a rape-free Nigeria. We are together with you in your desire to enthrone a society that will have a zero tolerance for all forms of sexual abuses on our women. And we will work with you, if you are ready to work with us, in pushing this advocacy even to further extents. There are fundamental issues that we must understand. We must end the conspiracy of silence. That's one of the ways we can actually fight against rape, sexual molestation, and other kinds of sexual assault against our women. The conspiracy of silence is driven largely by the fact that majority of rape incidents in our homes, in our churches, in our offices, within the political circle, in our schools are never reported.
The group is calling on government at all levels to declare a state of emergency against sexual harassment and sexual-based violence in Nigeria. Omole Timothy, Pride News, Abuja.